What is your definition of failure? According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, failure means a lack of success. To the logical assumption that follows is that you're only successful when you reach your end goal. In other words, the process doesn't matter. It's spelled out in black or white terms, it's either success or it's failure. This disempowering definition is one of the primary reasons why people fear endishpis failure. You could argue that it's all just semantics, but language shapes your behavior, so it's important to use the right, empowering words. You might consider the following few paragraphs a bit esoteric, but please bear with me and you'll probably start seeing failure in a new light. If you face a difficult problem and you tell yourself, "I don't know how to deal with it," you'll think of reasons why you can't do it and not potential solutions. Your brain acts on your instructions, and it's the words you use that steer your thinking process. How likely are you to solve the problem if you're wasting energy coming up with excuses, if instead you tell yourself, "Okay, let's find a way to figure it out," you'll think of potential solutions and probably solve the problem. Same problem, different words, different outcome. Let's illustrate this with a quick example. John and Kate want to start a business. Both come from the same background and have the same exact resources at their disposal. John says, "If only I had money, I could start a business." His disempowering vocabulary if only fine-tunes his brain to come up with further excuses why he can't start a business. Instead of telling herself "if only," Kate says, "I don't have money, and this means I need to figure out how to bootstrap my business." Her brain receives shy quality instructions and she comes up with several ideas to start a business in a shoestring. Same problem, different words, different outcome. It's not an unproven theory, discovered by some Martin Meadows guy. The concept that language has a big impact on our life is one of the staples of performance coach Tony Robbins' effective coaching process and has been proven to work with hundreds of thousands of people all over the world. 3. The basic premise of this concept is also the foundation of nonviolent communication, a communication process developed by Marshall Rosenberg, 4, in which replacing one word with another can make the difference between an unproductive fight and successful communication. Scientific research also suggests that words are powerful enough to induce a behavioral change. In one study, calling a carrot an X-ray vision carrot increased consumption of this vegetable by 16% among elementary school students. 5. And this effect isn't limited to gullible children alone. Adults offered the choice in a cafeteria will rate the taste of traditional Cajun red beans with rice more favorably than the taste of red beans with rice, or compliment grandma's zucchini cookies more than those described simply as zucchini cookies, even though they're eating the exact same dish. 6. As powerful as our brains are, words can fool them, and you can use this phenomenon to your benefit. I hope that by now you're convinced that words matter on a deeper level than you think. Let's change your definition of failure to something more useful. The American Heritage Registered Dictionary of the English Language defines failure as the condition or fact of not achieving the desired end or ends. 7. If we play with this definition a little, we can develop a more empowering way to think about failure. This definition talks about the desired end. If instead of making your desired end solely about the final success, but instead define it as learning, you'll never again fail in the traditional sense. You'll also start considering failure your friend, and not a reason to give up. If you focus on the learning experience, you'll realize how flawed the common definitions of failure and success are. You build success through trial and error. It's the failure and the lessons it provides that turn you into a winner, not avoiding it. Sticking to what's known, easy and comfortable is a surefire way to not reach your goals. When a shy man chats up a woman and she rejects him, did he fail or succeed? To an average person watching the interaction, the man has been rejected. He failed. But did he really, if his intention is to overcome shyness, or in other words, to learn something, the outcome of his approach doesn't matter. His desired end is to learn how to become more confident. He was brave enough to step outside his comfort zone and talk. Viewed in terms of his purpose, a rejection might have been an even better outcome than getting a woman's phone number, because repeatedly getting rejected helps him get used to it. In rock climbing, my favorite sport, you learn more on a difficult route you can't finish than on an easy route that you climb effortlessly. It helps you pinpoint weaknesses you need to address and uncovers your true character. Dealing with difficulties and the fear of a potential fall also sharpens your mental game and helps you become a better climber overall. If your desired end is learning, is taking a fall a failure or success? Is it really better to climb an easy route and succeed, with no learning process, or fall off a difficult one, but learn something new and become a better climber? In martial arts, for training purposes, losing can be more valuable than winning. When you lose against a more able partner, you discover your technical shortcomings. When you crush a weak rival, there's little to no learning. Is getting beaten a failure if you learned something new you otherwise wouldn't have learned? As Josh Waitzkin notes in his book The Art of Learning, An Inner Journey to Optimal Performance, great ones are willing to get burned time and again as they sharpen their swords in the fire. 8. Beating weak opponents, crushing easy problems, or doing things well within your comfort zone might make you look good in the eyes of other people, but it's challenging yourself that leads to improvement and long-lasting success. Challenging yourself and persevering in spite of difficulties isn't easy by any means, and we'll spend more time with this topic in a later chapter. For now, make a mental note that failure and success are two sides of the same coin, and one cannot exist without the other.